We have a serious
problem.
What's up?
I don't dive anymore. If that's only a problem, then I'll say no. You're gonna offer me money.
I'll still say no.
You're gonna appeal to my better nature. And I'm gonna say no. Because I don't have one. So I say, why don't we sit down, we'll enjoy a couple of beers, and then we can get you on your way.
Jonas, this happened this morning.
Lori, I have a contact.
Oh, it's huge.
It's crushing me. There's someone down here.
They may have encountered the same species you did down there.
It's a shark.
It's a megalodon.
Excuse me?
I said
a megalodon. A living fossil.
Thought to have been extinct for over 2 million years.
Wrong. A lot of people are gonna die if we don't find it and kill it. She's coming.
Of course you'd think it's a she.
It's a great day to go fishing.
He's kidding, right?
You saying we opened up a superhighway for giant sharks?
No, just a meg. I'm gonna make this thing bleed.
Hey, don't close out, stay with me, as I have more sci-fi for you. Did you know that Stanley Kubrick destroyed almost all of his props and sets from 2001, A Space Odyssey, because he didn't want them to be used in any lesser science fiction films? The spacesuit costumes in Ridley Scott's Alien were so poorly ventilated that the cast was passing out from CO2 inhalation. And Terminator 2 Judgment Day is the only sequel in the history of Hollywood to date to win an Academy Award when its prequel was not even nominated. What's your favorite sci-fi film? Let me know in the comments below. So, keeping with the sci-fi theme, I have some interesting facts from sci-fi movies for you. The unedited original version of Alien had a runtime of around 190 minutes, which was eventually reduced to 170. The Thing had two characters named Mac and Windows. In Gattaca, Uma Thurman's character is called Irene Cassini, named after Italian astronomer Giovanni Domenico Cassini, who discovered the four satellites of Saturn, as well as the distance between each of the rings of the planet. Now, according to bodycounts.com, which counts only on-screen killings, not characters killed in planet explosions? The movies with the largest body counts are The Lord of the Rings Return of the King with 836, Kingdom of Heaven with 619, 300 with 600, Troy with 572, and The Last Samurai with 558. Have you seen all these movies? Did you know there were that many killings? Let me know in the comments below. Okay, so a lot goes on behind the scenes while making a movie, and sometimes things get out of hand. While filming Rocky IV, Dolph Lundgren punched Stallone's chest so hard, his heart slammed against his breastbone, causing it to swell, and his blood pressure shot to over 200. Filming was halted as Stallone was flown into intensive care for 8 days. Also, during the filming of Resident Evil Retribution, a platform collapsed, 16 people were injured, and the EMTs had a difficult time distinguishing actual injuries from the special effects. Did you notice any behind-the-scenes action? Stuntmen and women have been around for a long time, stepping in for various scenes. Now, the first Hollywood stuntman was ex-US cavalryman Frank Hanaway, who was cast in The Great Train Robbery from 1903 for his ability to fall off a horse without hurting himself. The first Hollywood stuntwoman was Helen Gibson, who doubled for Helen Holmes in the first 26 episodes of The Hazards of Helen from 1914. She was trained as a trick rider and married to cowboy star Hoot Gibson. Okay, action movie fans, I've got a list of 10 of the most violent action movies ever made. Coming in at number 10, Dredd from 2012, directed by Pete Travis and starring Carl Urban. Number 9, Mel Gibson's Braveheart from 1995. Number 8, 2003's Old Boy, directed by Chan Wook Park. Number 7, Natural Born Killers from 1994, directed by Oliver Stone and starring Woody Harrelson, Juliette Lewis and Tom Sizemore. Number 6, Sylvester Stallone's John Rambo from 2008. Number 5, Robocop from 1987, starring Peter Weller. Number 4, Battle Royale from 2000, directed by Kinji Fukasaku. Number 3, Martin Scorsese's Casino from 1995, starring Robert De Niro, Sharon Stone and Joe Pesci. Number 2, Quentin Tarantino's Kill Bill. And number 1, Mel Gibson makes it onto the list again with his 2004 film The Passion of Christ. So, what do you think? Do you agree with this list? Hey, don't close out, stay with me because I have a really cool movie fact. Did you know that during the chest bursting scene in Alien from 1986, director Ridley Scott had the actors unexpectedly showered with actual entrails bought from a nearby butcher shop so that their screams of horror would be real? Now, if I would have been doing that scene, my scream would have been one of the loudest. What's your favorite Ridley Scott movie? Let me know in the comments below. Well, I've got some more action for you with an interesting fact from Independence Day. The scene in which Will Smith drags an unconscious alien across the desert was filmed on the Salt Flats near Salt Lake in Utah. The line where Smith says, "And what the hell is that smell?" was unscripted and was actually referring to a rotting smell of dead shrimp coming from the lake. That's all for today. Subscribe and ring the notification bell to always receive the latest trailers the moment they are online. Bye bye!